Hello guys, and welcome to this video about one of the most important questions for us at the beginning of our careers especially, which is what to prescribe for dental pain, okay? So we need to achieve the management of the dental pain for our patients. And sometimes we need to do this with prescriptions. So let's understand a little bit about this. We have three main key points and then a secret fourth key point, which is very important as well, and you guys will know why. So the first key point is we need to understand the type of pain, okay? So basically we have the three main types of pains that we find in our careers, the pulpal pain, the periapical pain, and then the post-surgical pain. Those are three basically different types of pains, right? And they can still have different behaviors, but we are going to talk about that soon, all right? The thing is that those pains are usually triggered by different factors. So feel free to pause the video and try to realize by yourself which are the factors triggering those pains, okay? And for those who are able to do it, congrats, we are going to start with the pulpal pain, which is basically triggered by hot, cold, or sweet, okay? That's how it's described by the literature, and we know that that's basically what happens. Then we have the periapical pain, which is the one when the patient is biting, for example, and the patient is feeling pain. Also, when we have tenderness to percussion, that's usually something indicating that we have a periapical pain as well, all right? And then we have the post-surgical pain, which is, of course, triggered by the surgical procedures. So the more procedures that we do and the more invasive they are, for example, we are opening a flap and then we are manipulating the bone, we are doing an osteotomy, for example, and of course those factors will affect the post-surgical pain as well. And all these pains, all these types of pains can behave differently. So we may have sharp and short pains, you know, in the case of, for example, if I'm talking about a periapical pain, like a fracture, a root fracture, for example. So this would be usually a sharp pain. And if we are talking about pulsating or persistent pain, then we can have these, you know, in a more chronic situations, for example, right? So those behaviors may be different, but we need to achieve pain management to all of them. And the pain can be also localized or diffuse, right? So in the case of a dry socket, for example, you guys know that we may have diffuse pain, okay, as well, right? And that's also pulsating and persistent in most of the cases. So that's why it's very important for us to understand what is the type of pain of our patient, okay? So you guys will proceed with a very nice history collection of the patient, a very nice anamnesis, and then you guys will understand better about the pain of the patient. So that's the first key point, and then let's go to the second key point, also very, very important, which is that we need to check the medical history of the patient for some contraindications, okay? So sometimes we want to prescribe NSAIDs because they are very good for the dental pain, but before we need to understand what to do here, right? So we may have patients that are currently taking an NSAID already due to another an unrelated condition, right? So maybe a physician prescribed an NSAID already to this patient. Maybe the patient has asthma and maybe the patient is pregnant. Why those factors are grouped in this screen, you know? And basically because we need to avoid NSAIDs. The NSAIDs will likely cause injury of the gastric mucosa. So in this case, we need to choose, for example, selective COX-2 inhibitors because they are so much better. They don't cause the reduction in prostaglandin, and of course, because of that, they will cause so much less injury to the gastric mucosa. It's also very important to understand that the different NSAIDs behave differently for those conditions as well. So for example, naproxen is the worst one regarding injury to the gastric mucosa, followed by diclofenac, and then the best one to avoid acid reflux issues is the ibuprofen. NSAIDs would still need to be avoided, but if we need to choose an NSAID, ibuprofen would be the best one for sure. However, in those cases, we usually try to control the pain. Instead of NSAIDs, we use paracetamol. Please note that in the articles, we may find acetaminophen or a PEP, so we can find those names as well. And if needed, the paracetamol can also be associated with an opiate like codeine in cases of severe pain, for example. So for cases of opioid addiction or for geriatric patients, then opioids can cause constipation for geriatric patients and can increase the addiction for patients with history of opioid addiction, of course. So In those cases, it makes sense to avoid opiates and opioids. And then for patients with cardiovascular disease, it's very important not only to avoid opiates, but also to avoid diclofenac drugs. For example, the sodium diclofenac, the Voltaren, or the potassium diclofenac, and of course I'm talking about the Catafast or the Cataplan. Please don't forget to check this recommended reference number 2 that you guys have on the screen, because it's very nice, and don't forget that those videos are made to orient and help your studies and not to replace all your studies. So then let's move to the next key point, so the key point number 3, which is of course to find our prescription compatible with the situation of the patient. So usually for popo pain, you know, the most common option will be the paracetamol, then we may need something else, right? So let's start with the most common situations. And then for periapical or post-surgical pain, usually we need something a little bit stronger because of the origin of the pain, and then that's why we usually start with NSAIDs. Please note that ibuprofen is considered the best one to control the pain, especially associated with arginine. And you guys have this article cited on your screen from Ramos and collaborators, published in the European Journal of Dentistry, describing the usefulness of ibuprofen associated with arginine, which is a salt that enhances the absorption of ibuprofen. But sometimes we have stronger pain, so we have severe pain, and then if needed, we can proceed with associations, right? So for example, we can proceed with paracetamol and ibuprofen, so paracetamol and one of the NSAIDs, or paracetamol and codeine, as mentioned in the slide before. Okay, so paracetamol and one of the opiates. Again, don't forget to check the references that are being shown on the screen, because they are very nice articles, by the way. One of these articles, the article from Moore and Hirsch, is describing a protocol for the doses in relation to the severity of the pain, okay? So for mild pain, for example, the authors suggest the use of ibuprofen 200 to 400 milligrams every 4 to 6 hours as needed, okay? For mild to moderate pain, the author suggests ibuprofen 400 to 600 milligrams every 6 hours in a fixed interval by the clock for the first 24 hours, followed by ibuprofen 400 milligrams every 4 to 6 hours until the pain persists, okay? For moderate to severe pain, the author suggests ibuprofen 400 to 600 milligrams associated with paracetamol 500 milligrams every 6 hours in a fixed interval for the first 24 hours, followed by ibuprofen 400 milligrams associated with paracetamol 500 milligrams every 6 hours until the pain persists. And then for the severe pain, the author suggests ibuprofen 400 to 600 milligrams associated with paracetamol 650 milligrams with hydrocodone, so another opioid drug, 10 milligrams every 6 hours in a fixed interval for 24 to 48 hours, okay? Followed by ibuprofen 400 to 600 milligrams with paracetamol 500 milligrams every 6 hours until the pain persists. Please realize that this protocol that I just mentioned is a protocol suggested for post-surgical pain. Then let's also remember as well about the common doses of paracetamol, which would be 1000 milligrams every 4 to 6 hours as necessary, okay? But with a maximum of 4000 milligrams a day. And that's especially important for paracetamol, as we know that the overdose of paracetamol can cause liver injury and can be actually dangerous for the patient. Then let's also remember about the normal doses of diclofenac, which would be 50 milligrams 3 times a day every 8 hours. So of course there are other possible combinations, other drugs that we can use as well on the dental pain management of our patients, but let's go for the key point number 4, and that's also very, very important. That's the secret key point of today, and it's for you guys to remember, do not use antibiotics solely for dental pain management, okay? So antibiotics are not effective to reduce pain associated to irreversible pulpitis, for example, as you guys can see in this article that is being cited on your screen now, okay? So if you guys have situations like this, for example, you guys have now this periapical radiograph on your screen and there are caries, and you guys are seeing that the caries are now reaching the pulp chamber and the root canal. So we need to do something else. We need to treat the root canal, okay? That's the best pain management that we can do for this patient. If you cannot see the patient, if you cannot treat the root canal, then you are going to proceed with the analgesics for the patient to wait until the appointment. But if you can open the root canal, please open the root canal instead of giving antibiotics for this patient. Please also note that I'm saying root canal treatment because I'm not considering the clinical situation of this patient of the radiograph. So sometimes, of course, extraction will be the indicated treatment depending on the situation and depending on the prosthetic plan as well. So those are the main key points, the tips of today about pharmacology for dentistry related to what we should prescribe for dental pain. If you guys liked this video, please hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to keep receiving videos like this, and see you guys on the next videos.